So when I first heard about the JAMStack, I thought that it was just web development because I couldn't really understand why it was a thing. It was just building websites. And I still think that, but now I understand it a little bit more. For newer developers on the scene, for bootcamp grads, for people who are teaching themselves, JAMStack is an amazing opportunity because you can build something incredibly powerful without having to learn too much. If you want to build a really powerful website that uses a database, has authentication, has a bunch of different elements that normally you would have to implement yourself or figure out how to run yourself, luckily with JAMStack, because everything is very decoupled, you could say, okay, I'm going to pull in this service for database. I'm going to pull in this service for auth, pull in this service for a CMS or something like that. And it can all be plugged in with APIs like Legos. And you can pull apart and add different bricks as needed. And it's a very great way to get into more advanced web development without having to learn from the ground up. Because you don't really have to learn JAMStack. You can learn a lot of different aspects of web development. And because of JAMStack, a lot of that has been made more accessible. The developer experience of the JAMStack is great because of the community around it. Because there's so many CMS companies, so many database companies, so many libraries, so many frameworks, so many parts of this JAMStack community coming together, because you can use all of them that way, it means that the developer experience can be fairly smooth and you can build how you want. Where a lot of times, if you have a very monolithic application where everything is connected all together, it's kind of like you've knit something together, this gigantic building of sorts as you're building your website. But with JAMStack, it's much more like Lego bricks, where I can put together my website in various chunks, and let's just say I want to replace my authentication system with something else. Because I'm connecting it with APIs, I can just take out those bricks and put in another brick, and theoretically, that's all I need to do. And that part of the developer experience of not having to worry about updating and adding and manipulating your code just to make a simple change is huge. And I think that's the best part of it, honestly, to be able to build these websites and not have to worry about what if I want to make changes later, because you can. I think because JAMStack is more like an ideology and philosophy of building websites rather than just this is exactly how you build a website, you can use pretty much any type of application as a JAMStack application. You can build it that way. And so as long as you're not relying on a server where you are maintaining the server or doing that, you can deploy pretty much anything to the JAMStack. And if you have, for example, a marketing website, that is great because it is mostly static. You could probably compile almost all of it up front and it'll just run. Let's just say you have more of an app-like experience. You could pre-build almost all of your app, except for the part that needs to be populated by users, and then you could client-side render some of that. That's totally allowed. You can combine the client-side rendering and the pre-building. If you want to have elements of a server, you could use serverless functions and add that in there to have your own APIs. It is a lot of practices that we know and love, and you can still build the exact same applications just with this kind of mindset of, again, compiling as much as you can upfront and then pulling in data as needed. Because when you're coming at it from an experienced developer perspective, you think, okay, JAMStack has a lot of static elements and then you add more here and there. And that is kind of what it is. It's pretty much like you compile as much as you can upfront and then you add in data as needed. You compile more as needed. That's the high level concept. And for experienced developers, you're just like, oh, okay, I used to make websites like that a long time ago. It's not a new concept, but it is a concept that I think has evolved over time, where now we have the power of better CDNs than ever, better caching than ever, better practices than ever, and just technologies and libraries and stuff than ever, where you can make incredibly powerful websites that combine elements of server-side rendering, of client-side rendering, of pre-building sites, and put it all together in a really powerful site that scales really well, pretty much automatically, where you have atomic deploys so you can immediately roll back whenever you want to. And also, if someone is smashing your site with a ton of traffic, it's not going to go down because there isn't a server that is the main thing hosting your website.